Hello everyone. Okay, so as we were doing the chapter number 5 of our class 8 history, that is when people rebel 1857 and after. So we have completed the topic the rebellion spreads. Okay, so in this topic, this was the main topic in which we got to know about 1857 and 1857 rebellion from Indians. Okay, this topic is a very deep topic, and about this topic you will read in your further classes. But in this chapter, in this class, you will read only this much about the rebellion spreads. It is the shortest explanation of 1857 rebellion. Okay, now here the company fights back. Okay, so basically the company fights back, me that shows that company have to suppress this. Company decided that they can't take this anymore, and now they have to anyhow repress this revolt with all its might. Here you can see with all its might means they have to do it by hook or crook. There was no option. So they mentally plus physically suppressed this rebellion. How physically? They fought. They had a war with Indians. They suppressed the rebellions by killing Indians. Okay. And mentally how? They made new laws. They made new laws and wanted to win back the loyalty of people, Indians. So that is why they have to do a lot of things so that Indians feel secure when there is a British government. Okay. All right. So here are some pictures in which it shows that how company fought back. So now here it tells how physically. First we are going to know about physically. So basically by physically means here that what they did, they brought reinforcements. Reinforcements means they brought forces from England. They called for forces from England and passed new laws so that the rebels could be convicted with ease. New laws, it is an example of mentally, okay? Now, first thing here comes that they have to suppress the revolts in the nodal points. And if you remember, the nodal points, here we have seen the nodal points of the 1857 rebellion were, here you can see Delhi, Kanpur and Lucknow. So first the Britishers make their target of Delhi. So they suppressed the rebellion which was going on in Delhi. On what day? On September 1857. Okay, September 1857. Just after the how many months? The rebellion started in May, June, July, August, September. In just 4 months, this happened. In 1857, September, Delhi was recaptured. All right, Delhi was recaptured by Britishers. Now, Delhi was recaptured. Who was the Mughal emperor at that time of Delhi? The Mughal emperor of that time in Delhi was Bahadur Shah Zafar. Bahadur Shah Zafar, alright. So on your screen you can see the picture of Bahadur Shah Zafar. And Bahadur Shah Zafar was captured by Britishers and he tried in a court. He was tried in a court, means there were some allegations over him to fight against the government. So he got a trial in the court and got a punishment of life imprisonment. Life imprisonment means for the whole life he has to spend the rest of life in jail. All right, now his wife also has to suffer because she belongs to the royal family. Okay, so her wife's name is mentioned in the chapter, that is Begum Zinat Mahal. Begum Zinat Mahal. Here, this is Begum Zinat Mahal. Remember, don't get confused in Begum Zinat Mahal and Begum Hazrat Mahal. So she was Begum Zinat Mahal. She also got life imprisonment, and their children. Their children were shot dead brutally by Britishers after the eyes of Bahadur Shah Zafar and Begum Zinat Mahal. It was a really very brutal way of punishing someone, to kill their children just after the eyes of their parents. Okay, so this happened with the Bahadur Shah family and Bahadur Shah. All right, now Delhi was recaptured. Now, this rebellion, the whole rebellion, this massive rebellion was not that easy, okay? Britishers took 2 years, okay? Britishers took whole 2 years to suppress this massive rebellion. Means 1857 plus 2, that is 1859. In 1859, this whole rebellion got suppressed totally by Britishers, but it took 2 years. Can you just believe 2 years? Now, in the next paragraph, we have got to know about Lucknow. Lucknow, we have just read about the nodal points Kanpur, Delhi, and Lucknow. Now, Lucknow was also taken in March 1858. Remember the dates here mentioned? March 1858. Okay? March 1858. Lucknow was taken in March 1858. And in Jhansi, what happened? So we know about that Rani Lakshmibai was also fighting. Okay? So Rani Lakshmibai was also fighting. So here on the image, you can see Rani Lakshmibai. She also fought and got. She also captured by the British. She also de got dead in 1858 in which month? Just 1 month later, just 1 month more than a year, that is May June. Okay, so she got captured or dead in June 1858. Okay. We have also seen the movie Manikarnika, and that we can you can see you can get more knowledge about 1857 rebellion. Okay, and we also know that she took help of who? She took help of Tantya Tope. Tantya Tope. So here on your screen the image of Tantya. So he also, but he didn't got dead simultaneously while Rani Lakshmibai got dead. Tantya Tope escaped. Okay, he escaped. He ran out of Jhansi and he escaped into the jungles of central India, means the Madhya Pradesh around area. And we know in Madhya Pradesh around area were having a lot of tribes, and we also know some of the one of the examples that is Gond tribe. So if you remember in the last class, you have learned about Gondwana, Gond tribe, and a lot of about that. Right, so Gonds and all other tribal people of Madhya Pradesh, he got escaped in among them, and also he had a guerrilla war. Okay, remember guerrilla war that has happened with the help of Central India tribal people, done by who? Done by Tantya Tope against Britishers. Okay, against Britishers. Now, but still he also got captured by Britishers in 1859, 1 month later when Rani Lakshmibai got captured in 1859. And now for your dates, I would like to tell that just remember, okay, here I'm showing you something. Okay, so the rebellion started in which month? May 1857. Okay, May 1857. And Rani Lakshmibai got dead just in 1 year plus one month later, May, June, and one plus 1 year also. Here, that is 1858. This is, I'm talking about Rani Lakshmibai. Now, just minus one, go minus one. In April, Tantya Tope got died. In April, okay, and in which year? Just you can't minus one here actually, because before 1857 there was no revolt also, right? So here just plus 1858 plus 1859. Okay, this is about Tantya Tope, this is when the rebellion started, and this is about Rani Lakshmibai. Okay, so April 1859 is the date for Tantya Tope captured, when Tantya Tope got captured, and June 1858 is the date when Rani Lakshmibai got captured, and May 1857 is the date when the rebellion started. All right, so this is clear now. Okay, now here it tells that just now I have already discussed about everything, every recaptureness of Now, 1857 rebellion was almost ended by the physical action of Britishers. Now, by the mental actions of Britishers, how did this rebellion ended? Okay, so what Britishers did, they simply said that the loyal landholders, means the loyal landlords or any landholder, farmer, peasant, will be having proper rights as they were enjoying their rights before, and they would not be having anything. Britishers won't do anything against them. Okay, but the landholders who rebelled, who took part in rebellion against Britishers but did not kill any of the white people and will submit to Britishers, means will surrender after Britishers, then their rights will be also safe. They will be also safe. Safety will be provided to them. Okay. All right. And the others who have rebelled and who have killed will be definitely will be tried and hanged or tried and killed by the Britishers. Okay. So this was all in this topic. I hope you got it. And if you got any doubt related to this, then please tell me. Okay, here it is also in figure 4, the Sage train reaches Delhi. So the British forces initially find it difficult to break through the heavy fortification in Delhi. On 3 September 1857, reinforcements arrived. A 7-mile-long Sage train comprising cart loads of cannons and ammunition pulled by elephants. Okay, so what happened? Sage train, it is a kind of, you know, like the trains carrying loads, or we can also the loading and unloading trains, kind of that. Okay, in Hindi we say it as Mal Gadi. All right, so this was all in this paragraph. I'm totally done now. Got any doubt, mention the comment box. I'll definitely answer as soon as possible. And thank you, have a good day.